Good morning. We're here with the director Lucio Caracciolo of Livius Magazine. In its next issue, Livius Magazine will focus on coronavirus and the worldwide implication of COVID-19. Director Caracciolo, the COVID-19 is the first modern pandemic disease. Some analysts say that transatlantic relations have already worsened due to this pandemic. Do you think that transatlantic relations have already worsened?
To some extent, yes. First of all, it's not really a pandemic. It's a quite selective epidemic because, for example, when you had the focus on China, we didn't have any serious attack from COVID-19 in Europe. When we got this kind of attack, the United States of America were not at the center of the crisis. You see, there is quite a shifting of this epidemic, which brings about some, let's say, advantages for some countries and disadvantages for others. China used her advantage when the United States were attacked and Europe was still in the crisis. For example, by starting some kind of aid diplomacy, which was very effective in terms of bringing about a serious surge of pro-Chinese sentiments in our public opinion, because we got, for example, masks, ventilators, and equipment from China, which we didn't get from the United States.
Thank you. How do you think transatlantic relations will change in the future?
Well, transatlantic relations will become more and more bilateral and less based on the NATO treaty, more on specific interests of the different countries and of the United States related to those countries. We already have many Atlantic relations. For example, it's clear that from an American point of view, for example, Pole is becoming more and more important because of its geographical position and of its historical attitude towards Russia, since Russia is now again, it seems, the main enemy on this front. On the other end of the spectre, probably countries like Spain and others are less revealing and less interesting from the point of view of Washington. At the same time, there is a sentiment here in Europe, also in Italy, that America is thinking and acting on the terms of the so-called America First strategy, which means that our interests are not considered.
How do you think Italy's European relation will change?
Well, we already saw some kind of change in this very special relations we have with some countries in Europe, because now the mood is everybody for himself, which means that there is no serious degree of cooperation, also in sanitary terms, also in health policies, between the major European countries. For example, we experience the closure of borders, the fact that some borders are becoming, if not walls, some kind of obstacle to normal cooperation between between countries, also in terms of trade, which is more and more difficult. Of course, in the next couple of months, I hope the situation will be easier. We will have to compromise between health protection and, of course, some kind of a surge of the economy. And this will be a very difficult balance.
Thank you very much, Director Caracciolo.
Thank you so much.
All the best.
All the best.